Yeah, I'm waiting for the response. Why do we use Google Analytics? What is the importance of using this tool? How significant? Because you want to track web traffic, yeah. So, things which we have covered till let us name one by one. We have covered that we have a website and now we want a traffic on it. In order to have that traffic, what all promotion means we can use. How to manage that website we have covered through a CMS called WordPress. Then we get into email promotions. Then we get into how do we go with search engine optimization in various parts. Then we went into how to have a paid advertisement after covering organic results. We covered into how we are going to use that for that tools. For that, we have used the tools in Google. We have used Google AdWords. For Facebook promotion, we have covered. For YouTube ads, we have covered. So that we have covered the promotion part. Now we are covering a topic like we have a website, we have a host with us, and there is, like you guys are saying, there is a traffic falling onto it. Now we want to analyze whatever business activity we are doing or whatever objective our website has. It can be an e-commerce site, it can be a content-oriented site, you know, it can be a classified-oriented website, but we want to track it down or what kind of traffic, yes, like you guys are responding. We just want to track it down what kind of traffic it is falling. Not only how much it is falling, but from which part of the country it is falling, or which part of the world it is falling, which way or medium it takes. We use these technical terms, but right now we are just discussing in layman terms what Google Analytics brings us on table. It brings us on table that who comes, how it comes, what are the background of people who are coming with interest and behavior patterns and all that. How long they retain with us, what navigation they does in our website. And this is quite a number-oriented tool. So it will be various reports which we can generate out of it, and we're gonna learn how do we generate that. We are gonna see it is a very in-depth topic, so we are gonna cover an outline of it, and the more R&D research and development we do into the subject, the more we get hands-on with it. So it requires a great deal of practice for all you guys to practice that, right? Okay. So first thing first, we have website on one end and we have Google Analytics on one end. How do we set up an account? How do we tell Google Analytics that you need to track this website and how it's going to track it? So let us cover that first. You need to go to a Google Analytics. It is already I've already logged in, but you can anyways. Search for Google Analytics. Go on with that. The home page may differ, so don't worry about that. And you need to sign in. You can sign in with your Gmail account. Once you sign in, it will ask for configuring it to a website. In order to do that, I need to go to a new account in that case. Wait. So let us see how it comes. No, it will take me to already which is logged in. The problem is I've just forgot the password, so if I log out. So never mind. On the fascia, you're gonna. See, I don't want to log out because I do not remember the password now. But anyways, once you log in, how it comes, it'll ask you for a sign in. Once you sign in, you'll be able to generate a tracking code. And that tracking code has to be put onto your website. So how to put a tracking code, that is very, I mean, to reach to the tracking code is very easy. That is the first step it will give you once you try to log in with your account. How to put it is thing which we will cover right now. So you have a tracking code, you just copy it like we have done in Google AdWords and other parts. So you can just copy it, go to appearances. I mean, I'm taking WordPress as an example, but you can share it with your webmaster, or you can share it with the developer who is, if you have made a customized site. So all you need to basically do is go to the header file and put it over there. So over here, the pattern is that you go to appearances, you go to editor. With every theme, you're gonna have one theme header. So any theme you have, you will have the header of the site. So click over there. The idea is that this tracking code has to be put on every page of the website. Now once you put it on to the header, it is there on for the every page. Over here, we need to look for this tab called head, and in between head and slash head, we need to copy and paste this tracking code. At the first time once you log into Google Analytics, sign into Google Analytics, you will get this tracking code. So you need to copy that and paste that. Okay, Ravijot, see, you need to understand, we want Google Analytics to cover all the things on our website. Who is coming, by which means it is coming, what navigation it is taking. Now in order to have that, okay, I'll tell you. Once you see, I've already logged in into the account. Once you make an account, here is the tracking code. So in your admin section will be tracking code. At the first time when you do sign in Google Analytics through your Gmail ID, here there will be an option of first of all, it will ask for basic information that you need to put your name, website name, and all that. And the moment you proceed to the next stage, it will give you a tracking code. The tracking code is, anyways, once you have made the account, is always available under the account. You can have 100 of properties to manage that. Under property, which you, let's say I have named it Nikhil Grover, you can name it anything. So you may name the property Pahari Tea, for example. And in that, you will get a tracking info and tracking code. So if you click that, this is the same tracking code which I have copied and pasted over there. Got it, friends? Why do we require tracking code? Because we are putting tracking code in every page of the website in order for Google Analytics to have a tag for every visitor to cover it up and track down all the activities of the website. Then only it will be able to give you a result, right? How many users have come in, for what duration they have stayed over there, and all that. So in order to have that, we need to have this tracking code. And this tracking code, which is Google Analytics, is giving us this tracking code, a unique tracking code with this tracking number. We need to copy this tracking code from here. We have copied it, and then we reached over here on the header of the file, and then we need to paste it. Once you do in on a header file, it will be there on every page. Now, how to check it out? I'll let you know how to check it out. You go to any page of the site, let's say for example nikhilgrover.com. View source, and in those source it will be there. So you can search just Control F. Yes, and write down search for analytics. See, here is the code. You can check it out. So you can check out at any page that will be there. Vishal, there will, like we have, see, it doesn't depend what CMS you use. In every CMS, there will be a theme, and in that theme, there will be a header file. You need to go to the header file of that theme. How to approach will differ from theme, from CMS to CMS. We are using this CMS. The header file is approachable in appearances and editor. The same way, there's going to be an editor over there in Muse. So you need to check the edit, go to the editor, reach to the header file, and header file in between header and the where the header is, where the head is ending, the slash head, you need to put the script, the tag which you have copied. Got it, Vishal? Got it, Ashalata and everyone? Till there. Anto, Karthikeyan, Mukesh. Why we are putting this? It's very simple. We want Google Analytics to track each and every activity in our website. How it's going to track it? We need to put a tracking code in every page so that it can track it down. Now, how the system is working now, once you have put the tracking code, is that a tracking code is there. Now, every user who is coming onto the website or any activity which is happening onto the website, Google is taking down that with itself, keeping it into its server, analyzing it over there and submitting your report that can be checked in our analytics report. You need to have the admin right. If you are using an extension of a blogger site, then probably you will not be able to do that because you do not have an admin right of that website. So the for any CMS you will be using, if you have the admin rights of the website, in other words, you can control the website, then for any CMS, there will be an editor over there. In an editor, there will be a theme, there will be a header file. So in header.php, like for example, I'm using this. In header.php, you need to go and paste it the way I've shown you. Every theme will have a different mechanism, but at the end of the day, it will have a header file. You need to go and paste it onto the header file so that it remains in onto every page. Anto says he can't hear me. Can you hear me now? Yeah, and if in case a site has been custom made by any of your developer or an IT team manager, then you just pass on this tracking code to him. There is also an email option, so you can just email directly to that person and he'll ask on behalf of you. How to check? I just let you know that you need to go to the page, any page. You just go to any page. Right click, go to source code and check it out over here. It will be there. Right? images. Coming on to the other account, because this account has greater number of data than to my nikhilgrover.com. Who all have already made the account for their website in Google Analytics? Achalata, have you made that? Anyone who has already made it? Good. So have you been tracking any numbers? Ravijo says no. Good. Anyways, so let us cover the basic premise of this account creation we have done. You need to understand that it's a reporting format at the end of the day. So the main USP of analytics is then you can have various reports out of it, and it is up to you how do you manage that and what numbers, what do you see beyond numbers, right? Like I've already said, it gives you a complete picture, like who's going to be there, how they have reached it, what device they're using, right? What are their interests, gender, etc. What behavior they use in your website, what behavior pattern has been, what navigation they have done. Like for example, if somebody stays on the comes onto the website but do not stay for a long, that is one behavior, or checks out to your login page or checks out to your contact page. So that kind of information is accessible over here. One more thing which I want to discuss theoretically before going on to the real practice of looking onto the reports, and this will be the session today where we're going to check out various reports which can be analyzed. These are, if I can devise that, your website is more or less can be categorized onto these formats. Like it can be an e-commerce, it can be a lead generation oriented website, a content based, a social media oriented, you know, a branding oriented website. At the end of the day, it will have various actions which are performed into it. And if we gonna keep track of what our objective while making a website is, and are we able to satisfy those objectives, are we able to fulfill those objectives during the course of our promotions, campaigns, advertisement, or general word of mouth, that should be the modus operandi of looking into the reports. Because in numbers itself won't speak. Like for example, our objective, if objective of putting a website like Pahari Tea, Vishal, I'm sorry, I'm just stopping in between to answer Vishal. So it's a tool more than a UX designer. Of course it's a tool, it's gonna give you reports. There's nothing which you can design over here. Do you recommend having newsletters and in a proper every page? No, I wouldn't recommend Ashalada to have a newspaper sign up at every page. That is, I mean, not required. In fact, it'll piss it off. And it loses the purpose of e-commerce. Yeah. But since you have asked this question, I'm replying personally on my behalf and not as a trainer for digital marketing, because as a trainer of digital marketing, I should be suggesting you to keep newsletter as prompt as possible, because you know that gives you a number of subscribers. Okay, Ravijot says it's not audible. Is it audible now, Ravijot? Is it audible now? I guess not. It is not audible to anyone. Are the others able to listen to me? Okay, Ravi is also saying yes. All right, so others are saying it is clear. Okay, so what I was saying, yeah, okay, I'm moving ahead now. But what I was saying is that whatever your objective is, do not lose the track of object, while looking onto the web, onto the numbers, onto the reports. Just do not lose track of the objective behind which you have, had the website. If PahariTea.com came into existence, it came for the purpose of selling tea, right? Now that is its main objective. Home entrepreneurs came into it. It came in with its own objective, not in terms of end sale, probably in the start, but giving, a content and giving a classified kind of format to the people at large who want to work from home. Right? So everybody had its different objective. Report will have its own parameters because it has to have a standard parameters. But a number can be a significant for PahariTea.com, but may not be significant for, let's say, HomeEntrepreneurs.com. In HomeEntrepreneurs, there is a higher number, even if the bounce rate are high, or even if the sessions is a little relatively smaller in terms of minutes, it does, because at the end of the day, they are only seeking their right information. But in terms of e-commerce like PahariTea.com, the session duration has to be more, or the number of page views has to be much higher, because it signifies a greater number of search in between of the site, and then greater possibility of looking onto various various pages or various products, and then buying it out eventually, right? So got it till here? What basic point I want to make? And I guess we both know what kind of sites I'm taking example, PahariTea.com as well as Home Entrepreneurs, which is Sangeeta's website, right? So clear till here? Achalata, Sangeeta, Mukesh, Anto, Vishal. Yeah. So as a digital marketer, that you just please do not lose track of it. Okay, so how basically GA functions, or like a question has been put, there is nothing to do with UX designing and all that. The point is, it's only a reporting format. You are only gonna get numbers out of it, nothing else. It's only, there are various metrics which can be used up to it, and this is what we are gonna cover today. So at the end of the day, what is happening onto your website, Google Analytics is basically keeping a data for it, a data collection, then configuring it, then processing it, and then reporting it. That is the basic activity of GA. Not unlike Google AdWords, where there is a great number of UX design orientation into its product. All right, now let's start basically. This is how, once you get into it, this is how it's gonna look like. It's a home page. So it is tracking this website. This website, I pulled it off due to reconstruction, but that's one of the e-commerce website which I've made into existence. So mania.com, you probably will not be able to see website right now, but you can check out its web social pages if in case you want to do that. It's under reconstruction right now, but I'm taking help of its Google Analytics tool of it to let you know how figures come into the picture, how reports come into the picture. So that's the home page. The area which you'll be spending a lot of time, in fact on daily basis if you're managing your website. Okay. Like reporting over here. So you'll be spending much of time over here. on reporting. Then you can also do a little customization of reports if in case you want to do that. And then the admin. And in admin, you will have your account settings, your tracking code information, your management information, the products which you are linked, and all that. But we'll be focusing more towards reporting now. You can look into this tool onto like on the left hand side over here. It will always come as a navigation panel over here. This which you can close or open. So we just will be covering each and everything one by one, right? Yeah, so be a little patient. There are various tools into it, so we need to decode each and every one by one. How do you view the tool is on the left hand side. We have this tool, a navigation bar where we can check out the dashboard. We can check out reports based on four major divisions, which is audience, as in the user base. So anything which is related to user, what demographies it has, what interest it has, from which location it came, how many total users came into the picture, how many new, how many repeat, what kind of session which they had, what kind of page views which they had, all those is covered under audience. I'll cover one by one each and everything. Then there is acquisition. Acquisition is basically from where it has come, the mode. Like for example, did it come from an organic search? Did it come from an AdWord? Did it come from which browser it has used and all that? So it will give you this kind of thing. Like if you go to an overview, you could see that it is giving a total response and how to have numbers and percentages. This will see once we cover one by one. Right now, just for the overview pattern, you can just check it out that this is how it comes, like how many of you came directly, how many of came via organic results, and how many of came via referral. Referral is nothing but an off-page optimization result. Then what behavior? Behavior as in your site, what was their behavior? What was the flow onto the website? Login page, and then they land up to whatever page. Order detail page and all that and all that. And then conversion, if in case you have set a goal. Over here there is no conversion which you can find, but if you set a goal, you'll be able to see conversions over here, right? So let us go to any of that. Let us go to this. All right. So clear till here. There will be Google Analytics is going to give us report on these four formats: audience. Okay, conversions are basically like we have used conversion in Google AdWords. Conversion is basically a setting up a goal where you can set, let's say, newspaper signing as one conversion, or buying now or ordering something is a conversion for you. So you can set up that conversion via conversion code the same way we have put the tracking code into the website. We need to put a conversion code. The only thing is, yeah, got it? The only thing is, it needs to be put on one page rather than every page which we have put on for Google Analytics. So once you do that, you're tracking your how the conversions are happening onto your site. Right, so clear till here. If I ask you on how many types we can have the reports, it is divided onto 4 minutes. Archana, I'll just come to your question. Audience, acquisition, their behavior pattern onto the website, and whatever conversions, if in case the goal setting have been done for our website. When you set up AdWords display campaign for the marketing, can you show us? Okay, keep this question for the last. we'll cover this question once we cover it on to the last. Yeah? Okay. Okay, Shodip, I'll answer you since everybody else have already covered the topic of convergence in the last session. I'm expecting them to know that. So any one of you can answer Shodip for now. Shodip, is it your first class? Okay, okay. It's okay. We'll let you know what is convergence. Anyone who wants to volunteer and answer Shodip? So Ashalata, I'm taking a leverage of using again pahadit.com. I know that will be a little difficult in explaining on via text. So let me explain over here. Now Shodhi, see, this is website of your fellow batchmate over here, Ashalata's website. It's an e-commerce. Yeah, I'll tell you what is conversion. Conversion is one of the objective which you have put into a website that I will consider for whatever my website. It can be an e-commerce website or it can be I know it will be very, very difficult for you guys to explain in via a chat and a text. So that's why I'm just explaining it. So what you take is you take an objective that for my website, I'll consider this activity or this action. If somebody performs this action on my website as a user, it comes from my website and perform this action is a conversion for me. That can be a newsletter sign up. If I do a newsletter sign up over here, can be a conversion which, you know, Ashalata as a digital marketer for her website has considered it. Or for her, this is not the immediate objective. For her, a conversion is if I go to any of the product. Sorry guys, the site is, my internet is moving a little slow. And let's say I go over there and I buy that. Right? So in order to buy that, the response is that I need to have an order summary page. So that order summary page is something which is a conversion for her. How do you track that is the next question you should come. Anyways, till here, Shodip, are you clear what is conversion? It is not only a form filling. A form filling can be one of the activities which can be conversion. If you deemed as a digital marketer that if somebody has filled the form for me, it's a conversion. That is my end objective of my website. If that is you consider, then you can on a form filling page when somebody fills the form and you know a thank you for your form for filling your page, if you have made that kind of page, that can be okay. Ravijot, is it, you know, that can be a conversion page for you. So clear, Shodhi? What a small overview. It's okay. But if I'll be you, my next question is how do you do that? Okay, Ravi just wants it to repeat. I'm repeating. Probably you guys were not there in the last session. That's why you didn't find it. A conversion is basically, I'm repeating it again and very quickly now. If I have a website like this, an e-commerce website, as a digital marketer, I need in addition to what my campaign is doing, I also need to track that through a, let's say, Google AdWord activity, somebody landed to my page. Anyways, Ravijot, do you know what is Google AdWords? What is a paid ad? Do you know that? The keyword, a keyword based ad. Are you aware about that? If in case no, then let me know. Otherwise, you won't understand what is that. Shaudeep, are you clear what is a paid ad in a and by using Google AdWords? Okay. So, guys, I'm just detouring for 2 minutes. Allow me to do that. Let's say I want to buy a. So Ravi Joe says, okay, you know. So let's say Ashalata is a digital marketer for her website is campaigning in Google AdWords. And in Google AdWords, I search for a Pahari tea or any tea and I landed to that link. I clicked onto the link, I reached over here. Now she wants to track that whosoever user is coming through that route and is buying the product eventually, or whatever activity she deemed that this is the activity which I will consider as a conversion, I will be able to track that. That through my this activity, ultimate conversions were this much. Like for example, there are total impressions which are made on Google AdWords for her activity for a duration of 1 week. For example, well, let's say 800 impressions. Out of that 800 impressions, 50 people only clicked onto that ad. Out of that 50 people, 5 people bought it, or 5 people made conversion. So that is conversion. Now, but that conversion is very, very subjective. It is all up to you as a digital marketer, what activity you want to put as conversion. So Sangeeta has replied something. Conversion is considered based on the objective of your website. For one, it can be someone buys for a product, for other. Very, very systematically put, and that is the exact answer. So that is a conversion. So Shodip, did you got it thoroughly? You can read to what Sangeeta has mentioned and what I was saying. So it, yeah. And Ravijot, did you also get it? Now, if I'm being you, my next question is, how do you do that? Technically, how do you do that? Do the same way we have done for Google Analytics. In Google AdWords conversion section, we'll get one tracking code. We'll copy that tracking code, and to whatever page we feel that this is the result of that action page, we put that tracking code onto that page. And from that point onwards, Google will start tracking it. If somebody, like for example, if somebody bought something, the next immediate page will be an order summary. Thank you for the order. This is your order number. This page is only visible to me as a user once I made a purchase. And if that was the objective of the digital marketer for that website, then he or she knows that the conversion has been made. Got it? So shall I move ahead now? Okay. So over here, these are the reports which I can check it out. Four main sections, and amongst four main sections, there will be various subsections and subdivisions of reports which you can do. If you look on the top, you'll always get to read of whatever category you are in. So I'm into audience and I'm looking onto the location report. So it is showing me a location report. If I click on to let's say age, it will show me that I'm checking onto under demographics, I'm checking onto the age. As simple as that, right? Then there is a feature over here of date. If you are looking onto any report, it has to be time bound. Like कौन सी डेट से कौन सी डेट तक की रिपोर्ट हम देख रहे हैं. सो राइट नाउ एंड देर आर वेरियस थिंग्स विच यू कैन प्ले अराउंड डेट एंड दिस इज समथिंग आई वांट टू स्ट्रेस अपॉन फॉर 5 मिनट्स एट लीस्ट. इफ यू गो इन टू रिपोर्ट एंड यू वांट टू चेक दैट आई वांट टू चेक ओनली लास्ट 7 डेज एंड अप्लाई. So every report which is gonna come over here is gonna come for the low for those last 7 days? Right? So let's say go to reporting. Got it? Now let's say I wanna, this is for a month on the selected date, and I only want to check last 7 days. Once I'm checking on the last 7 days, I also not only want to check only last 7 days, but I also want to compare it week by week, let's say, for example. So I have a feature over here called compare to. Once you compare to, it will take by default, it will select the default period of whatever you have selected as a data range over here, a date range over here. But you can also select the other period of whatever you want to mention over here. So let's say I'm selecting the this week with this week. So my current week is blue week and my previous week is orange week. Click over here. I could see that this is how it is coming, right? It will show me, right now I'm checking new versus frequency, but let's say I want to check on these dates, I want to check, let's say overview. I want to check how many total people came, what were the session durations and all that. So I could check the number of users rose by 2.21%, but my session got decreased. What is session duration? What are user duration? What are page views? Let us start one by one. What are sessions over here? Anybody? Make a guess. What can be the session? Yes, it is in addition to a hit, Ashalata. Now how it goes is, if I come and engage to the website, it's a session. So if I'm there for, let's say, 10 minutes hovering around, that's one session. If I went away and then I came back, yeah, it's a time spent. So it's basically time spending on that. So it refreshes itself after 30 minutes. So if I'm there for 45 minutes, it will count as two sessions by default. So that is session. Page views is different. In one session, I can have various page views. I can have 5 page views. I can have 2 page views. I can have only one page view per session. But session is basically the engagement. And page views is anyways page views. Users, we know. And this is what it is giving me. That in duration of the report I have fetched out for this date, the page per session rose by 2.52. As in one session, how many pages were there? 2.52% increase in that. Minus is, see, I'm comparing these two right now. So that is why it is giving you a minus sign, that onto the week from February 14, 2016 to February 20th, the average session duration and the average session duration of this week, there is a decrease of 5.61%. So in this week, I've suffered a loss, or this website has suffered a loss of average session duration of 5.61%. Sessions is basically number of sessions, and the average session duration is average session duration. Right? You'll get it clear. You'll get a little confusing because it's comparison. If I remove comparison, you will be able to understand better. So if I've removed comparison and I'm only checking report for the overview of the audience for last 1 week, and you could see that there are total 202 sessions which happened onto the website. 139 users came into it. There were total 1470 page views which happened onto the website. The pages per session were 7.28. So anybody who landed onto this website had an average page session of 7.28. Now this was the point I was making when I was saying that do not lose track of the objective of the website and what is your best result. Like for example, I'll take on one side I'll take pahadiri.com and I'll on other side I'll take Home Entrepreneurs on the other side. For pahadiri.com, the page average session pages per average session per session, if it's high, it's good. But if it's for Home Entrepreneurs, the more it is high, the better it is, because it for pahadiri.com it has limited number of products and the objective is that, you know, it lands up to few pages of it of his or her own choice which user wants, check it out for the product and then making an ultimate purchase or getting exit from the website. But a classified kind of site, the pages sessions has to be more, so there is more exploration going on. It's more of a seeking of more information, like you are in a OLX or a, you know, or a site like that. So there you want this pages per session to be much more higher. Got it? Average session duration is 6 minutes and 59 seconds for an e-commerce site. It's okay, average. For a now comes to a bounce rate. What is bounce rate? Anybody, by name it is little evident, but let's make a guess. Let's make an interactive and then I'll answer what is that. What could be the bounce rate? What does bounce rate means? And what do you think that is a significant percentage for it? User not going to any other page. Yes. Up to some extent, yes. But it has one more line to add into it. Asalata. Came and got suddenly without staying. Yes. Came and immediately getting an exit. Now that is bounce. So you are bouncing back. Bounce rate of 30% is, it's okay. It's pretty okay. It is not very bad and it is not very good also. A bounce rate more than 50% is concerning. A bounce rate in a range of 20-25-30% for e-commerce sites is okay. A bounce rate less than 15% is very, very good, but it is very hard to achieve. Bounce rate less than 5-10% is, I mean, I'll be happy with the bounce rate. Now that is one more thing for all you guys on a lighter note. Do not consider these numbers as significant numbers because we are finding little difficulty onto the operations. Okay. So for streamlining that, we have pulled out the website. So any number which you see over there is hardly any activity done on that front. So anyways, yours is 75%. Don't worry about that. In the starting, it will be like that, because you are not doing any activity around it. So, like for example, I'll give you, if you consider me, I've used your website many a times in the examples also, right? So, if I logged in and just log out, it will be considered as a bounce rate. So, that can be one reason. So I'm one of the culprits, Achalata, over here. But, I'm also one of the reasons to add onto sessions, because I retain longer over there also. But, don't worry about that. A bounce rate will be higher in the starting for any website, and then start and respectively start going down. Plus your product is also not very image oriented product, so you can have that kind of thing. For a newbie, Shodip has asked a question. For a newbie, what see bounce, that is what I'm saying. A good percentage is 20 30 35. That is a good percentage, 40. But it also depends, like I've always said in As a digital marketer, do not always take the tools as it is. It is more of a brain job. So, because at the end of the day, you are marketing. So, it also depends on what kind of website you have. For a brand-oriented website, for a catalog-oriented website like Maruti's website or let's say BMW's website, you'll find they'll have bounce rate anyways relatively lesser because if somebody comes with a purpose of looking onto the catalog, looking onto the site and for company information and something like that. So there a bounce rate of 35-40% for Maruti is actually very worrisome. For you it is good if it's a new website. For Ashalata it will be a remarkable situation at her situation because she's just started the business. For home entrepreneurs, for Sangeeta, it will be a significant percentage. So it depends on what kind of strata you in, what stage of business you are in, what kind of website you are. It all depends. And then you have to signify of what kind of percentage you feel is a significant percentage. But as far as I'm concerned, you can take an average for a new blog-oriented website or let's say e-commerce-oriented website. Anything between 25, 30, 35 is good. 50 above is concerning. I mean, then you have to look into the what should be done, what changes should be done so that you know it happens. That rate becomes good. I mean, good in the sense it decreases down. Then you see over here a return visitor versus a new visitor comparison. Now, an e-commerce always expected to be, frankly, the situation which is currently, it's in between. They're more happy. So they want 50% at any given point of time, 50% to be return, you know, a retention and 50% to be a new because new is their thrive, their thrust for business. For e-commerce always want new customer every day, otherwise they'll go down, right? But you would see that for a content, a blog-oriented website, like for example, a NikhilGrover.com, I would be happy if I see more of a returning visitor, because then the word of chances of word of mouth becomes high. Okay, Vishal has asked a question. So, as a digital marketer, how we can put over input in content to a website designer? No, I didn't get your question. Can you just come again? As a web digital marketer, how we can put over input in content to a website? Vishal, I'm just taking a pause for 1 minute. Can you just come again? Oh, I didn't get you exactly. How can we put over input in content to website designer? And you probably got the question, I've answered that, but I didn't get exactly what you want to ask. Can you just phrase it in any other way? Yes. Vishal, is there any confusion? You are always asking question on in terms of designing. Were you expecting a website designing course out of it? I'm sorry guys, I'm just taking a detour to talk to Vishal so that there is no confusion over here. Or you are a digital or you are a designer, what? I mean, or you are expecting a designer course, this to be a designer course. Were you expecting that? Vishal, I'm just waiting for the answer. Can you just please reply? Everybody is waiting. Oh yes, branding exercise are all linked. Creative media, everything is linked. And you cannot think away from being a designer. But what designer are you right now putting a question as? A designer as in how the site is going to look like or a website designing in itself? And what was your question anyways? Right now we are covering Google Analytics, right? So branding designing will cover as it comes, and there were various topics which were covered in terms of various subjects and subtopics which are covered in during the course. But right now we are focusing on Google Analytics. So we have anyways covered how to design a website via CMS. We have covered that in one or two sessions, Vishal. Then we have also covered our designing advertisements, reaching to the website and all that. So since we are on to the 10th or 11th session of the batch, we are here that you have already made a website and now you're tracking down the situation of the website. Yeah, Sangeeta has anyways answered. I was just about to answer. So you please come on to the different batches which will have this topic pending. Unfortunately, the batches which I am running, I've already covered that and nowhere near I'm going to cover that. But let's say by probably the end of March, I'll be in a one or another new batch where I'll be covering this topic. So you can just coordinate with admin and ask them to be on my or any other batch in DMP where you can cover that. Anyways, friends, sorry, I'm coming back again to the topic. So this is a date comparison, which is very, very important and essential, because you can not only cover week wise, you can cover month wise, year wise, and then you can also compare it. Then the comparison is also possible in onto whatever reports you're looking going on to this way. Like for example, okay, I'm sorry, I just missed one important point, and that is I'm writing it down over here. Dimension versus metrics, right? There are two main lingos, there are two main subjects in analytics. So any report which you view is under the review of dimension and metric. What is dimension? What is metric? Dimension is basically for what you're looking for. Yeah, the action, the characteristic which you're looking for, it's basically on the x-axis. And metric is the result, the numbers, the quantifying result of it. So over here, if I want to this report, I'm looking onto the metrics of how many sessions happened. Now these are metrics, right? Returning visitor, new visitor, these are dimensions. So whenever we are going to use dimensions like demographies of country, city, you know, which browser it took, if you go to age report, what different age groups were there, these are all dimensions. What was the end result is the metric. So these are the dimensions that age between 25 to 34, sessions were 67, the total sessions were 93. So these are metrics. And these are, what are metrics? Session, new per sessions, new users, what is the bounce rate, pages per session, all these are metrics. And these are dimensions, x-axis, y-axis. So got it? What is dimension and what is metrics? This is very, very important, friends. Ashalata says yes. I'm waiting response from everybody because I won't move ahead until unless you have any doubt in that, because otherwise you won't understand any report. Ashalata says yes. Okay. Now we can also compare two metrics in one versus other. That is also. So in whatever report we have. Okay. Anto is saying that he wants me to repeat dimension and every report Anto in Google Analytics has two lingos, have two words to define it. It will be on two bases, x-axis and y-axis. So any information you look. You look for dimension as in what characteristic, what end result you want to look into it. That is called dimension. Like for example, if I want to check with location, so if I see I'm checking a report for किस किस लोकेशन से मेरे पास क्या क्या आ रहा था ना. दिस इज द लोकेशन फ्रॉम इंडिया आई हैड 139 सेशंस ऑन टू द पीरियड व्हिच आई सेलेक्टेड. फ्रॉम यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स आई हैड 13 सेशन. फ्रॉम चेक रिपब्लिक आई हैड 5 सेशंस. सो इनटू दिस रिपोर्ट आई कुड सी दैट दीज आर द डायमेंशंस राइट. लाइक आई एम लुकिंग अ रिपोर्ट फॉर लोकेशन अंडर डेमोग्राफ अंडर इंडिया. इफ आई गो beyond India, it will have its states and regions over here. From Tamil Nadu, I got this response. From Delhi, I got this response. From Maharashtra. Now, all these over here are dimensions. The characteristic, for which I want the action. And these are metrics. These are called metrics for what end result I want out of it. The quantifying result of what I was looking for as an information. I was looking how many from Tamil Nadu have come to my website in this duration and how many sessions they had. What was the bounce rate? If that was my end objective of looking onto this report, then over here, when I thought that I need to track down how many from Tamil Nadu came, that Tamil Nadu is the dimension I'm looking, how many came, and what was the result? That it has 69 sessions, it has a bounce rate of 24%. These are metrics, the quantifying result of the dimension. Got it, Anto? Okay, so is it like my target to achieve means dimension? Not precisely, because you could achieve. Wait. My target to achieve means them. Yes, what you achieved in metrics. But there could be sub dimensions also. So in one way or the right, yes, you are right. In one way or the other, you are right. All right. Okay, now I was covering, let's say we have been covering this, that I want to check that from this location, what was the end result. But I also want to compare it with, let's say, on a graphical mode. Right now I'm covering graphical, not on the table mode. So in a table mode, you can anyway check it out. But let's say if I want to just compare on the graphic mode, I want to compare two things. First of all, I want to see that how many from India came. So I go to locations, and in over here, you'll have two ways to look into it: map overlay as well as explorer. So I go to the explorer one, and I see that this is the thing. So in this week, I want to only check for India, and this is the end result of my. So from India on 21st, I had 4 sessions. On 22nd, I have 21 sessions. Then on 19 sessions, on 23rd, on 24th, I have 24 sessions. This is the report, and it keeps on increasing it, and last day it got dipped. This is the report. But I also want to compare ये sessions हो रहे हैं, but इसमें से bounce rate क्या जा रहा है. So I can just over here only I can select the other thing which I want to compare it, and let's say I want to compare it with bounce rate, and this is the bounce rate. So I got a bounce rate in a light blue line, so I could see that the bounce rate has a tendency of moving this way end to end, point to point. So it's all up to me how I want to see that. I want to compare it with any other, I can compare it with average session. So I can compare it with anything. Over here also I can select the other metrics. So on to the dimension which I have selected as the India dimension. Within India, I'm selecting these matrices and I'm comparing these metrics. So right now, what is my dimension over here in this report which is currently open? Can anybody tell me what is the dimension? Yes, region is the dimension. And on the graphical view, what are the two metrics I'm comparing? Or what are the matrices opened over here? Is there one matrix or there are two matrices? I'm waiting for the answer, guys. If you look onto this graphic view, yes, there are two metrics, sessions and average session duration. I can also look into the week view, which will give me nothing, it will only give me average thing, because my whole population was only week. So I come back here. Week you can check once you are checking, let's say, a month or a quarterly report, and then you can check out week wise and month wise. And there is one interesting kind of graph, this one. Okay, I have had a problem, so probably it will not run. It is called a moving graph. It's a motion graph basically. It will be open. Can be opened into your own browser, so you can check out in your browsers. Once you click onto this, it will give you a motion pictures, like on 22nd it was like this and on 23rd it was like that. So there will be jumping buttons coming over here, so you'll get the idea of what, you know, what was the movement, did it came up, did it came down date wise. But I'm sorry guys, there is some problem with flash pair, so I'm not able to show you over here. Right, so let us go for a month. I want to show you one thing. Now there is one thing called annotations, which is also important. Now I'm looking onto this report, and let's say I've done some activity on 26th, or let's say on 24th or 25th, and I want to record it, because once you're looking onto so many data, you also want to keep notes of it, that this is the activity I've done. And you know, this is the result it has. So you can create an annotation on a date. So you looking onto this, that's on 20. You want to create an annotation that on 26th I've done a marketing campaign. Let's say an online campaign, or let's say I've written a new blog, and I'm expecting to rise a new blog written. So You want to share, you want to keep private, whatever you want to do, let's say you've done that. So whenever you are checking around these dates, it will come as an annotation and you will be able to check it out with the notes. So whatever you are looking and you have something in your mind, you can just go over here as annotations and create an annotation and mark a note for it, that this is the activities you have done due to that something has cropped up or the results are coming that way. All right, friends, clear till here? Any doubt? Okay, so now let us start moving. Next topic, okay, there is segmentation which is left, and then we can check out all the reports. Let's say we are on. This is the first view that you have reports on audience acquisition behavior and conversions. So once you go into audience, you could have an overview, active user report. I'll tell you what is cohort analysis just in a while. Then on the demographics, you can see what is the overview of demographic report, age-wise, gender-wise, interest, location-wise, and all that. But if you want to subdivide a report, which is not a metric which is not available over here, then what to do? Like for example, I'm into, let's take this example. I'm into again this. So I've divided into location, I've divided how many in New Delhi. Now I want to check in from New Delhi how many were returning, how many were new and how many were returning. So I've reached to this, but how to reach to another metric? Oh, sorry, another dimension. I'm on to one dimension. If you can look on to here, I've reached to a dimension where in demographics I've reached till location and I've also reached till New Delhi. But now I want to know that in New Delhi only, what is the other dimension result? That other dimension can be anything. Like I want to, in New Delhi, I want to compare how many came new and how many were returning. So over here, I can go and add a secondary dimension into it. So in secondary dimension, I go to behavior. Well, this is site behavior. If I'm under, let's say I'm doing it again. I reach to location. I selected one location. It is showing the results of other, but not this one. So let us say I want to check it out for into these locations. I want to check what was the age comprehension. So that is the result. So under one dimension, I add another dimension and start looking into it. I guess there is a way of segmentation which you can do to reach to this. I'll try to do that now. But anyways, did you got why to add second dimension? Because with one dimension Broadway, we reach to one report. That is that I want to check onto the locations of India. How, what is the result? How many sessions took place? What were the new users and what are different metrics? These metrics. But into it also, I want to look into the age group. So for that, I need to go and select the secondary dimension. And I can select age, or I can go with, let's say, the other patterns. Can select gender, and I could see that in Tamil Nadu I had this many female and these many male sessions. So like you can see from Tamil Nadu, the bounce rate for female is higher than for male. Right? So this way you can add another dimension and check it out. Got it? Vishal, Shodip, Sangeeta, Ashalata, and two. Okay, Ashalata is saying for some reason that GA does not show any data for these dimensions. For region one, demographies, then your demographies tab was not active. Yeah, so your demographies tab is not active. You need to go to, there are other ways also, but one of the ways is you need to go to admin. And then check it out over here. There will be, no, I just kept my mind. Like for example, you can see a site search tracking is off or on. There will be, I need, you need to just check out these options, Ashalata. Check it out, somewhere down the line it was off, it will be off. So you just need to switch it on. Okay. Then on a module level, there is one thing which is left, which is adding a segment. Now, what is adding a segment? More or less, we have covered all the module level. Then there will be reports which will we can check at a faster rate. One thing, like for example, we have selected. Again, getting onto the same example, we went to, let's say, geographical locations. Achha, on the map view also, this we have not covered. You can have a map view, you can have an explorer view for some of the reports, especially linked with geolocations. So once you get into here, you can also click and directly reach to that. So you can see that this is the range. It is much darker. That means majority of audience is coming from here. It is quite obvious. But there are audience which is coming from across the globe due to whatever reasons, and they're coming over here, right? So you can just click that and reach. And over here you can just look onto the map view, and it will give you a reference that from the northern part it is not having a good response as it is getting from the southern part. So you can make your next strategy that you want to traffic from north, or you only want to concentrate on south, and you want to select it for next Facebook promotion or any other promotion, you want to focus on which area. So it helps you out in even determining that. Let's say I clicked over here. And this is the table view. So I'm closing map view now. I guess it's quite obvious what is map view. Now let's say I can add a secondary dimension, but over in the secondary dimensions also I want to have a little filters, or I do not want, let's say I want to look into this, but I do not want one or more dimension amongst it. So I can do a segmentation over here. Let us do a practical example of what do I mean. So these are the previous segmentations which are done. This is the group which I always check for female in this group, because our website is female oriented. But you can have a segment basis on your understanding. So what you do is you click on to new